Hello, everyone. Nice to see you again. 很高兴又同大家见面了。今天我们要学习的课文有一个很美丽的名字 The Crystal Palace， 译成汉语是水晶宫。不过这篇课文讲的可不是孙悟空到海底的水晶宫找龙王借兵器的故事。那么它讲的是什么呢？看看下面的生词和短语能不能给大家一些提示。 Palace， Extraordinary， Exhibition， Iron， Various， Machinery， Display， Steam， Profit， College。从生词和短语的情况来看，我们要学习的课文好像没有什么神话色彩，倒是工业味儿挺重的，大家说呢？ Okay, now let's have the text and the cartoon, and the four questions will accompany you. Where was the Crystal Palace built, and for what purpose?
水晶宫建于何处？为何目的而建造？
What made the Crystal Palace different from all other buildings in the world?
水晶宫的什么地方使它与世界上的其他建筑不一样？
How many visitors came to the Great Exhibition?
有多少人参观了这一次大型展览？
What happened to the Crystal Palace later?
后来水晶宫遭受了什么？
Perhaps the most extraordinary building of the 19th century was the Crystal Palace, which was built in Hyde Park for the Great Exhibition of 1851. The Crystal Palace was different from all other buildings in the world, for it was made of iron and glass. It was one of the biggest buildings of all time,And a lot of people from many countries came to see it. A great many goods were sent to the exhibition from various parts of the world. There was also a great deal of machinery on display. The most wonderful piece of machinery on show was Nasmyth's steam hammer. Though in those days,Traveling was not as easy as it is today, steamboats carried thousands of visitors across the channel from Europe. On arriving in England, they were taken to the Crystal Palace by train. There were 6 million visitors in all, and the profits from the exhibition were used to build museums and colleges. Later,The Crystal Palace was moved to South London. It remained one of the most famous buildings in the world until it was burnt down in 1936.
好，我们的课文听完了，动画也欣赏完了。前面提出的四个问题，大家都准备好答案了吗？一起来看看吧。Our first question is, where was the Crystal Palace built?And for what purpose? The answer is, it was built in Hyde Park for the Great Exhibition of 1851. 第二个问题是 What made the Crystal Palace different from all other buildings in the world? 答案应该是 It was made of iron and glass andIt was one of the biggest buildings of all time.
第三个问题
How many visitors came to the Great Exhibition? Well, altogether, about 6 million people came to the Great Exhibition.
最后一个问题
What happened to the Crystal Palace later? It was moved to South London,And was burnt down in 1936. 这样一个耗资巨大、凝聚了无数人心血的水晶宫，就这样在一场大火中消失了。我们一方面感慨人类无穷无尽的创造力，另一方面又不免为这样的结局而扼腕叹息。好，闲言少叙，现在我们一起来看看课文中的语言点。首先请看 Which was built in Hyde Park for the Great Exhibition of 1851. 这句话中出现的 Hyde Park, 大家知道指的是什么地方吗？对，就是伦敦非常著名的海德公园。当年马克思也经常光顾这里，参加各种集会，聆听各种演讲。下面请看课文中的这个句子。The Crystal Palace was different from all other buildings in the world, for it was made of iron and glass. 这句话中有两个语言点，请大家关注。先请看 different from。 Be different from 的意思是与什么什么不同，请多看几个例句。The meeting was different from any that had gone before. 这次会议和以前的会议都不同。His message is very little different from theirs. 他的信息和他们的没有什么不同。再请看 be made of 这个词组。它的意思是由什么构成，比如 The houses were made of brick. 这些房子由砖头建成。What is the furniture made of? 这些家具是用什么制成的？好，我们再来看这句话。A great many goods were sent to the exhibition from various parts of the world. 这句话中出现了 a great many, 它的意思是数目非常巨大。请多看两个例句。I remember going to London a good many years ago. A good many 也等于 a great many, 所以这句话的意思是我记得好多好多年前去伦敦。The information has proved useful to a great many people. 这条消息对很多很多人都很有用。另外，课文中还出现了 a great deal of machinery on display, 以及The most wonderful piece of machinery on show. 请注意 on display 和 on show 的意思都是展出的。课文中还出现了一个 though 引导的状语从句。Though in those days, traveling was not as easy as it is today, steamboats carried thousands of visitors across the channel from Europe. Though 是一个表示转折的连词，它的意思接近于汉语的虽然，但是在汉语中虽然常与但是连用，而英语中用了 though 就不再用 but， 如果用了 but 通常就不再用 though， 所以我们刚才的这句话可以改写成In those days, traveling was not as easy as it is today, but steamboats still carried thousands of visitors across the channel from Europe. 但是我们千万不能说 Though in those days, traveling was not as easy as it is today, but steamboats carried thousands of visitors across the channel from Europe. 这是 中国的学英语的学生非常容易犯的错误，大家平常一定要格外留神。 On arriving in England, they were taken to the Crystal Palace by train. 这句话中有一个 on 加上动词的现在分词构成了短语，这个短语的意义大致相当于一个时间状语从句，表示一怎么怎么样，就怎么怎么样。所以呢，这句话我们还可以改写成 Soon after they arrived in England, they were taken to the Crystal Palace by train. 好，课文中的语言点我们就讲完了。在下面的部分呢，要请大家看看形容词和副词的比较级和最高级的用法。这篇课文中一共出现了四次形容词的最高级，分别是 The most extraordinary building of the 19th century, One of the biggest buildings of all time, The most wonderful piece of machinery on show, One of the most famous buildings in the world.那么我们怎么把形容词构成比较级和最高级呢？这时候就要看音节了。一般说来，单音节词和一部分的双音节词是通过在词尾加上后缀 er 和 est 来构成比较级和最高级。请看几个例词。 long longer longest lateLater, latest. Big, bigger, biggest. Happy, happier, happiest. 多音节词和另外一部分双音节词要通过在形容词前面加上 more 和 most 来构成比较级和最高级。请看几个例词。Difficult, more difficult, most difficult. Beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful. Interesting, more interesting, most interesting. Actively, more actively, most actively. Often.More often, most often. 另外还有少数的形容词和副词，它们的比较级和最高级比较特殊，需要我们逐个进行记忆。请大家看一看 ：good, better, best; bad, worse, worst; many, more, most.Little, less, least. 比较级适用于两者的比较，请看几个例句。Mary is older than Jane. Mary 比 Jane 年长。There are more parks in Beijing than in Shanghai. 北京的公园比上海多。The Summer Palace is more beautiful than Zhongshan Park. 颐和园比中山公园要美。最高级呢，用于两者以上的比较，请看例句。He is the tallest boy in his class. 他是班里最高的男孩。China has the largest population in the world. 中国在世界上人口最多。 OK, 关于比较级和最高级我们就总结到这儿。我们这次课文是围绕 The Great Exhibition 来展开的。 The Great Exhibition 也就是我们现在所说的世博会。大家都知道，再过几年，上海也将成为一次世博会的主办城市了。对于这样的大型展览，一向是仁者见仁，智者见智。有的认为大型展览能带来商机无限，有的则认为纯粹是劳民伤财。Well, do you think international exhibitions serve an important purpose? Okay, that's all we've got time for today. Thank you for being with us. See you next time.